Hey everyone, I'm back from not making videos for a freaking month because of school. Today I'm gonna be teaching you how to stretch your ears via the taping method. The taping method is slow and steady. It's not a race to stretch your ears, and you wanna make sure you do it properly because I've fucked up my ears in the past. But it's seriously so much better to stretch your ears slowly with the taping method. It's cheaper and it's just like an overall good time. A lot of people have different opinions when to start the taping method. I think it's okay to start the taping method if you have a 2 millimeter gap. Like, I used the taping method between the 2 gauge and 0 gauge because it was kind of hard to use a taper to stretch up and stuff. And like anything smaller than that, you can just use a taper. It's really easy to just slip your taper in and put a plug in and then wait a few months. I used the taping method to get from 9/16, which is 14 millimeters, to 5/8, which is 16 millimeters, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. What you're gonna need is PTFE tape, which is basically Teflon tape. I always wanted to do this. Like, I'm not going to use is regular tape, electrical tape, or anything like that. Use plumber's tape, PTFE tape, or bondage. Also gonna need jojoba oil or vitamin E oil, emu oil, or even bio oil. What I like to use after I've stretched my ears is holy butter. Holy butter is fucking great. It is vegan and it smells like a forest. A lot of people don't like the smell, but I think whatever smells like a forest is fucking great for me. You're also gonna need a surgical steel tunnel or plug, single flare, don't use a fucking double flare, that's hard as shit, a glass plug or Teflon plug, any material that is safe for stretching your ears. Acrylic is shit for everything that you're gonna do with your ears. I know some people can wear acrylic in their ears, no problem, like they'll wear it 24/7. It really isn't great for your ears. Acrylic sucks. And it's really slippery and hard to work with jojoba oil. Trust me, I've tried it. I'm gonna show you how to actually tape your plug or tunnel.
Start off with a healed lobe. Make sure you wait 6 or more weeks between stretches, and even more if it's bigger. Take your holy butter and massage that bad boy. Massage it right up. Make sure it's nice and massaged. Take your PTFE tape and wrap it evenly around your plug or tunnel. Make sure it's nice and even and wrapped securely. Make sure there's no gaps like this. Look at that. It looks nice. Then take your jojoba oil, vitamin E oil, whatever, and slather that bad boy. Make sure it's nice and moist. Then you're gonna slip it into your ear.
If it hurts, if there's any resistance, you're gonna have to take one layer of tape off. You have to wait 4 days, 3 or 4 days between stretching. So you're gonna have to put one more layer of tape each time you stretch. Start off with 3 layers of tape or less, no more than 4. I only used 4 because it was fine for me, it was fine for my body. I started stretching my ears to 5/8. I only stretched one at a time because I only had one steel tunnel. So I got this one up to 5/8 in like 2.5 weeks. Then I put this tunnel in, and then I tried to stretch this one in. I tried to do the same thing, and I got impatient at the end and tried to pop the 5/8 tunnel in there. So basically I tried to dead stretch. Didn't work. I tore my ear, but it was disgusting, and I had to wait 1.5 months to stretch again. It's very important to be super patient. If it hurts, if you put a layer on and like you can't get it in without it slipping perfectly in like butter, it's gonna suck. They'll feel like crap. So it took me 2.5 weeks and 11 layers of tape to get from 9/16 to 5/8. And now look at my ear. My ear is perfect and happy and fine. So that's what it looks like without anything right now. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope you have beautiful angel-kissed ears at the end of it. Remember to stretch slow and use safe materials, okay? Don't wear tapers. You're gonna look like an ass. Love you!